What's up guys, it's Earthball here, and welcome to Super Mario All-Stars. So today, we're going to be playing through the original Super Mario Bros. Game, the remake, on Super Mario All-Stars. So last video, I played through all of World 1, and then I showed a bunch of secrets, basically all the secrets, but I've come to realize that I missed a couple of secrets, so I thought this would be a cool way to, you know, show them all to you. And also, because I'm currently working on the World 2 video, and World 2 is hard. Like, really hard. So I thought I would just go back to World 1, you know, something more in my zone a little bit, but the castle level is still really hard. So, let me explain what this game is. So, this is a Super Mario Bros. Remake for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System, or the SNES. Which is like the new Nintendo console, right? After the NES sold like a bunch of copies, a bunch of machines, and then like Nintendo kind of got rich off of it, they were like, hey, this is a great idea. Since our old console sold so well, if we make a new console, it'll also sell really well. So they developed the Super Nintendo. And back in like 1993, which was when this game was actually released, only like the cool kids, the rich kids had one of these, but soon lots of people had them. So Super Mario All-Stars was like, basically the story kind of is like, they created Super Mario World, like a Super Nintendo Entertainment System, like exclusive, or at least I think it's an exclusive. And like, everyone hated it. Like, almost nobody played Super Mario World. Like, it sucked. And I don't like it either. So they were like, crap. Because, like, whenever you have a Nintendo console, kind of what you expect is a cool Mario game that comes with it. And since nobody liked Super Mario World, the console wasn't selling as expected. Okay, well, probably, it wasn't just because, like, of the Mario game, but kind of because of the Mario game. Because, you know, it wasn't that exciting. So, they were like, crap, what are we gonna do? The Super Mario World kind of didn't work. So what are we gonna do now? So what they did was they just took all four of the games that had already been released for Super Mario, which were Super Mario 1, Super Mario Bros. The Lost Levels, Super Mario Bros. 2, and Super Mario Bros. 3, and put them into one cartridge and then sold it as Super Mario All-Stars. And that's how this game was born. So the idea was they would just like take the old games, make them look a lot cooler. Also, if you uncover, break the ceiling here, you can actually see the word bonus. It's fun. Okay. And so they just took the older games and they made them look better. I mean, they tried to make it look better. I still like the older style much more. I don't know. Why don't you guys tell me in the comments? I'm actually genuinely curious to know. Because is it just me that hates these graphics? I don't know. I just don't like them, okay? Because what I feel like they did was they just took the old games, which were super cool games, and they just made them look like Super Mario World. And I really don't like that. Because Super Mario World, I feel like, isn't a good game. Like, sure, you get to play with Yoshi a little bit, but Yoshi is, like, the only cool thing in Super Mario World. The enemies are weird. Like, the movement is weird, the controls are weird. Like, I don't know why, I don't like it. So, since their, you know, flagship Mario game on the Super Nintendo was kind of failing, they just made the remake of the older games, and they sold it off as All-Stars. And one of their major selling points was Super Mario Bros. The Lost Levels. And in later cartridges, when they actually added Super Mario World to the cartridge, you know, to sell it more, because I don't think the All-Stars version sold that much anyway. I don't think it sold a lot of copies. I think it sold, like, almost none. But basically, later on, they actually, I think I might have the cartridge to show you. Might do that at the end of the video, but basically they put the Super Mario World on the same cartridge as Super Mario Brothers All-Stars, you know, in an attempt to make more money. Which might have worked. Might. If the game, you know, was this bad selling. Because a lot of people already had the Nintendo Entertainment System, and they weren't looking to pour all their money into a brand new console that had, like, nothing new in it. So nobody was really buying this game because the console was underperforming. So I'm just gonna get to the point. So one of their main selling points was the Lost Levels. It was unreleased in the United States, and later on, when they did add Super Mario World to the cartridge, they also added a little stamp on the Super Mario Brothers The Lost Levels, like, icon, saying, unreleased in the USA. So it was a pretty big selling point, because everyone wanted to check out the Lost Levels, which was unreleased in the USA. And in Japan, it was released as Super Mario Brothers 2, which is why sometimes you hear it referred as Super Mario Brothers 2J, or 2 Japan. That's why you sometimes hear it be called that. So what I'm wondering is, if you kill Bowser regularly, like normally with fireballs, it turns into like a fake Goomba. Oh my god, that's still a thing in this game? Wow. Alright, well, we didn't even lose once in that. I'm so surprised. That was a quick playthrough. I've gotten a lot better at this game. I might even play a little bit into World 2, because this is a very short video, and I haven't even finished saying my story yet. So, the All-Stars version had the Lost Levels in it. It was a fun remake. They tried to make it look better by making everything look like Super Mario World. I mean, it doesn't look like Super Mario World. It looks more like Super Mario Bros. 3, but those graphics didn't look that great either. There is a 1-up mushroom there if you collect all the coins in 2-3, in 1-3, or you warp. Other than that, I don't know a lot of secrets here. There's a coin heaven, I know that. There's a secret coin block at the end, but not much more. This is a power-up. Okay, but not much more. So, I really don't know what I'm doing in World 2. I have a map that shows me a bunch of secrets that I made, so that's what I'm using for my, you know, video. Man, thought that was a coin block. Okay, whatever. Okay, well, since the Lost Levels was unreleased in the USA, they tried to make it look, like, super cool. Like, hey, our cartridge is, like, the only one that has the Lost Levels. Obviously, it didn't really work. Okay, there's the stock. My god, I've never even seen a vine in this game. I don't play this game much. There's a bonus in this guy? That's really funny, and the vine looks super weird as well. What is that platform? I don't like this game anymore. Why does it look so weird? You can see some people really didn't like the game because of its awkward physics and look. They fixed a bunch of hitboxes, which some people liked. Most people didn't. So this is the end of the level, I believe. Man, why am I just doing so well today? I'm actually in a pretty good mood. Spring look like that, what? Okay, so, you know, if you know what you're doing, you can just get up like that. But back when I started playing the game, I had no clue how to use this thing. I was like, huh? Huh? Wait, what? Why do I randomly go up there? Why do I not? So to help the people that don't know how to use Spring, there's a little coin block here, and you can just smash it, and... and you can just smash it, and... Why? And you can just smash it, and there you go. You're on top. Just like that. So, the Lost Levels, I guess, was fun, but it kind of underperformed as well. And when it was finally released in, like, 2015 or 2005 by Nintendo as its own independent game in the USA, it wasn't that popular anymore. For pretty obvious reasons. Oh my god, the water level looks so ugly. What is this? It looks so bad. Oh my gosh. This looks so bad. I cannot explain how bad this looks. I'm just gonna put all my foot. Alright, first death of the day. That's exciting. A lot more to come. Trying to concentrate. Dang it! So you can't go through coral. But the background coral doesn't matter because it's in the background. You probably didn't need to know that. But anyway, the All-Stars version really didn't do that well in terms of sales. And almost nobody has it. Like, I know a lot of people have the cartridge for, like, the original one on the NES. But, like, nobody has the All-Stars cartridge. Probably because both the console and the game underperformed. No, there's not gonna be a lot of copies off there. If both of the things that you need to get the cartridge were in low demand. Like, really low demand. Alright, beat 2-2. So yeah, end of the story. It just really didn't sell that well. And the Super Nintendo didn't sell that well either. I believe it ended up starting to pick up because of some other game, don't know. But it was just kind of Nintendo's desperate attempt to get people to buy their brand new console for like $6 million. You can see a lot of things are different. The music is very different. Bam 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 bam. Instead of the do 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 do. Very different music. Underground music is way different. Water music is way different. They changed some of the physics as well. I believe now, instead of having to go in a downward momentum to kill things, you just have to land on their head, which is a big improvement. Super nice. And I missed the jump. Come on. Damn it. Alright. That green platform, I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that's a checkpoint. I don't know. I don't know why there's golden statues of Goombas in the background. That wasn't there in the original. So they changed the physics. They fixed the piranha plant hitbox, so no longer is it like, you can jump over the top half of the piranha plant. Like, I don't think it's like that anymore. The Cheep Cheep look way different, but they're still as dumb as ever. Really, the big issue is that you miss the jumps. I mean, the Cheep Cheeps are annoying, sure, but it's decently easy to avoid them. This last bit, I hate, personally. And the Cheep Cheeps are actually annoying in this part. And the reason is, like, the second you're about to jump, a Cheep Cheep hits you, ruins your jump, and then you just fall. Alright, 2-3 beaten. Wow, I don't know why I'm doing so well. I'm literally covering the entirety of World 2 right now. If I beat Bowser, that would be so funny. I don't think that's gonna happen, though. 2-4, I have not practiced at all for this level. Oh my gosh. But I'm still gonna try my best to see what I can do. They also, because Super Nintendo was just a better console, like a more powerful console, the entities and enemies and stuff don't really despawn. So I know in like World 1-3 in the original, like the platform could like despawn because there were too many Goombas on screen or whatever. That doesn't happen anymore. I believe in like 5-3, which is just a 1-3 map but harder, they kind of screwed that up because of all the bullet bills everywhere, you were sure to get like a despawn, right? Something was gonna despawn. Something was just gonna despawn. And nobody liked it when that one platform they were jumping to despawned. So to fix that, they made the Super Nintendo a more powerful console so that it can, you know, do. You can perform better, so that isn't a thing anymore. Also, the older game was incredibly easy to hack. It was all in the ROM. I might make a video about me trying to hack the game. Obviously, when you don't know what you're doing, it's pretty hard to hack. But when you know what you're doing, I think it's pretty easy to hack the original. In this game, however, you can't really hack this thing, can you? Because, like, the cartridge is way bigger. I think the file is way bigger. The dot, whatever, the executable for the SNES is. Okay, we're going to go through here. We're going to go through there. We go through there. Okay, here we go. Don't screw this up. Don't screw this up. Don't screw this up. Wait, I can go on top then? I've never done that before. That's a first. Here we go. Under. Go, 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 go. Usually I'll purposely take damage there so that I can just tank the hit and get the beat. But I just beat 2-4. Why am I doing so well? Oh, there's two toads? That's super cool. That isn't there in the original. But it didn't cover any of the secrets. So you're still gonna have to watch the World 2 video if you want to get all of the secrets, which is probably why most of you click on these videos anyway. Oh, great. Now we see Paracoopas. And Paracoopas and their counterpart, I guess, the Hammer Bro, are annoying. Like, they are so annoying. Oh my gosh. Okay, well, I didn't lose, surprisingly. I did not know what I was doing there. Oh, there is a secret one up here, but I didn't get all the coins in 2-3, so I don't think I'm gonna be able to collect it. We'll see. So, I don't think every single, like, bonus stage is stored in the same map anymore. And yeah, that is a fun fact about the original Super Mario Brothers. All of the bonus stages were actually stored in the same world. So if you got some kind of cheat code to disable the anti-scroller, you could technically go from world to world because of their bonus stages. Yeah, I didn't get all of the coins, so I can't get the one up right here. Unfortunate. Hammer Bros are going to be right here. So this is a checkpoint, because Hammer Bros suck. And then here are Hammer Brothers. I just killed one of them. The best way to kill them is to smack them from under until they come to your level. And then the best way to kill them is to just not and just run away. There's a secret right here. I'm not sure if I can get to it, though. Let's try it. You have to get a almost precise jump up into here, and then you can get a vine there. Okay, here we go. Cool, okay. Cool. Let me take the time to go ahead and just say, this cloud platform, it has a smiley face on it, and I hate it. It looks so goofy, and I hate it. Like, what is that? The old one looked so much better. It looked like a bunch of beads together. And that just kind of takes you to the end of the level. Get some coins here. There is a thing you can perform in the original game where you just, like, hit these Koopas perfectly in the exact angle, and then you can do the thing, and then you can get infinite lives. But I'm not good enough for that. And there's no checkpoints after that. Right. Here we go. Okay, don't jump down. Come on, dang it. They both came down. Alright, well, that's gonna be the end of the video. I really don't want to continue. So, hopefully, you enjoyed the video. So, let me just, it's .oops. Okay. So, as you can see here, we have the lost levels, SMB2, and SMB3. Now, I might have the file. Here it is. I don't know what any of that stuff means. But here it is, Super Mario All-Stars plus Super Mario World. And as you can see, they've got Super Mario World right here. And as you can see, it says unreleased in the USA. Unreleased in the USA, very exciting, you know. And then you go in, play it, and then it's not that fun. Because it's ridiculously hard. I might take the... Since the video is quite short right now, I'm actually going to go ahead and play some Super Mario Bros. 2. Which, I hate this game so much, but I really want to get some practice on this game, you know? I want to try some of the elements. Some people told me that I can pick up... What? I can do that? How did I never know about this? This is the first Mario game to introduce doors as a thing. So you can literally just toss the enemies at other enemies. That's really funny. Okay. Well, you just pick up vegetables in this game. It's kind of boring, honestly. So I'm gonna go up here. I don't know what I'm doing. I have no clue what I'm doing. What is this? Wait, it just summoned a door. Hold on, get me in this door. It just summoned a door. Hold on. Wait. Wait, hold on. Come on. I need that mushroom. Come on. Dang it! So there's a time limit on it? Great. That's just great. Oh my god. I don't know what's happening anymore. Okay. This is POW. I've never played this game. I think I played it once, actually, but... I don't like it. I didn't like it, so I just didn't play it anymore. But, I mean, I guess you could see how some people can call this fun. I personally can't call it fun because it looks so bad. Like, what are those enemies? I don't know. But really, what I'm here for is testing a secret that I saw on YouTube. And it is, you can go to a specific location somewhere and then you can get a 1-up. I didn't even know 1-ups existed in this game, and if you can get a 1-up, that would be super cool. Oh crap. The original Super Mario Bros. 3, it was hard. You got like two lives. You got two lives. That's all you get to face this ridiculous game. So you got two lives. Even less than the original game, you get two lives to do whatever you need to do here. And I was just like, I hate this. Like, I did not like this game at all. Like, I never liked it. Alright, what are those locks gonna come back up? Yeah, okay, good. So apparently this is a 1-up? No. Maybe on top of one of these. Oh, it was next to the POW block, that's what I saw. So, need to get up here and pick this up. 1-up, oh! So I just got a 1-up, cool. And I can use this POW block. POW. Man, this game is actually very exciting. What's that? Oh, I'm Invincible Mario! Oh, I'm Invincible Mario. Get me in this door. I don't know what it does. What is this? I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, I'm up here now. Okay. I guess. Throw that. Okay. This is pretty cool. This actually isn't a bad game. I think it's just like a reskin of some other Nintendo game. It just kind of needed a new Mario game, you know? They were like, okay, we're kind of like, Mario's super exciting. Everyone likes Mario. We're gonna make a new one so we can make more profit. It was called like Super Mario Bros. 2 Mario Madness, right? The Mad Mario. The really Mad Mario. Okay, can I get up there? Nah, of course not. Yeah, crap. Well, that's about it for this video. I hurt my feelings. What is this? I can't exit out of the game either. How? This game. Can I exit, please? No. Aw, come on. Dang it. Well, anyway, that's gonna be it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video and my really dumb story. And goodbye.